Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you where the gateway logs are, except I don't know where they are. At least at first I didn't. I was dealing with a customer, and they were specifically asking, where are the gateway log files? So, you know, we like to do things here on Guy in the Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I'm going to start with the actual on-premises data gateway configurator or the UI, whatever you want to call it. The first thing I know is that when I want the logs, I go to diagnostics and I say, well, give me the gateway logs. And what this does is it actually exports the log files to a folder on your desktop, and it's a zip file, right? And so in the zip file, we've got all sorts of things. We've got gateway errors, we've got gateway info, we've got gateway network, all sorts of good stuff. So where are these files on the hard drive? And they couldn't find it. So I was like, well, we need to figure this out, right? So my first thing I was going to do is I was going to ping someone on the actual gateway engineering team. And I'm like, wait. I've been doing this for a long time. I can figure this out, right? So it's a personal challenge for me. How do I actually go about figuring out where these files are? Your first guess may be, well, let's just search for the files. Cool. So let's go ahead and extract these. And I want to grab this file. So let's see if we can find this. So I'm just going to go to my C drive and we'll say, search for this file. And surely it will come up. And then I got excited. Yes, there's the file. There's only one. Wait, what's that? Look at that. File path. That's the file that's on my desktop that I just grabbed the file name from. Okay, so it couldn't find it. So what next? I know there's a folder for the service count of the gateway that's in one of the user locations. So what account is the gateway using? It is this NT service/PBIEGW service. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my users folder and I should see, but I don't see. There's no PBIEGW service folder here. I would have expected to see this here because the service count's going to be here just like my user account. Okay, so that's not there. So it's getting these files from somewhere, right? So if we do gateway logs, it's extracting it from somewhere. So what other things do we have? Well, it's coming from the file system, right? It's coming from your disk. And so what do we have out there that we can look at that can monitor the disk? There is a tool out there from SysInternals called Process Monitor. So you can get this up on the Microsoft site. I'll have a link down in the description below. I've been using this tool for a long time. And this is a way you can monitor your disk, your registry, and other things. So let's check that out. So I've had Process Monitor running in the background. And one thing you'll see in the lower left is you can see this thing is just grabbing data. It's been running for a little bit. Now, one thing I'm already pre-filtering is I'm saying don't include the registry, don't include network activity, don't include process and thread activity, and don't show profiling events. So I'm only looking at file access here. All right, so let's extract the files. All right, there it is. And then let's stop the capture and let's search for gateway. Oh my gosh. Sometimes searching can be faster than others, but there's a lot of info here that it needs to go after. So let's do this instead. We know it was towards the bottom. So what I'm looking at is this process name. I want to see, there we go. So I see Enterprise Gateway Configurator. So now what I can do is just go ahead and let me say only include this process name. So now we've just said ignore everything else. I only want to see the process name that's here. So let's scroll down until we see something that looks familiar. What I'm looking for here is the gateway logs. And there we go. That's the exported location. So I want to know where is it actually getting for, and then we can see this item down below. And so here we can see it's C Windows Service Profile PBI EGW service. That's where that service account folder is. And then it's under app data local for that, which is where you can find that information. Super cool. I was actually talking to Alex Powers about it, saying, hey, FYI, did you know this? And he came back and said, well, it's actually, if you're using Rui Romano's gateway monitor tool that he has out there, it's actually in the configuration file. And I'm like, of course it is. I went the long way, but it was interesting and I learned some things. So let me show you his GitHub repo. So if we go over on Rui Romano, so it's PBI GTW monitor, and there's a config.json file which has the gateway path listed here. And so you could just quickly figure it out from there. And if you end up switching the service count that the gateway is using and you're using that tool, make sure you change the path for where it's going to go grab that information. If you want to know more about the gateway, be sure to check out the playlist up above. It has different videos and I'll be adding to that over time. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.